Welcome to my channel Fee Concepts CHM. This is the sixth part of the band theory of solids, where we are going to discuss about the motion of electrons in a one-dimensional periodic potential. Motion of electrons in an one-dimensional periodic potential, where we will derive the expression for effective mass m star of the electron. For a free electron, p, the momentum, is given as h cross k. This is the true momentum of the electron. But in a periodic potential, h cross k is not the true momentum, because E does not vary with k as it does in free electrons. Here, the concept of crystal momentum arises. We use the crystal momentum conservation principle. When such an electron is accelerated in a crystal, its mass is different from the free electron mass m, which is called as the effective mass m star. Now we will derive the velocity of the electron. From quantum mechanics, the velocity of the electron in one-dimensional lattice is given by the group velocity. V is equal to d omega by dk, equation 1, where omega is the angular frequency of the de Broglie waves. Also, E is equal to h cross omega. Differentiating this equation with respect to A, dE by dk is equal to h cross into d omega by dk. Rearranging this equation, you get d omega by dk is equal to 1 by h cross dE by dk. Equation 2. Substituting equation 2 in equation 1, we get the velocity v is equal to 1 by h cross into dE by dk. Equation number 3. Now we will verify for free electrons. E is equal to h cross square k square by 2m. Differentiating this equation, we get dE by dk is equal to h cross square by 2m into, we have differentiated k square, we get 2k. 2 will get cancelled out and you get dE by dk is equal to h cross square k by m. Equation 4. Substituting equation 4 in equation 3, we get V is equal to 1 by h cross into h cross square k by m. So 1 h cross will get cancelled out. So we'll get h cross k by m. Substituting k is equal to 2 pi by lambda, we get h cross by m into 2 pi by lambda. Again, substituting lambda is equal to h by p. Here, this is h cross by m into 2 pi into p by h. Also, substituting h cross as h upon 2 pi, this h and this h will get cancelled out. 2 pi and 2 pi will get cancelled out and we get p by m. This is equation 5. So this equation gives a linear variation of V with k. This is for a free electron. We'll see these diagrams one by one. The E versus K graph we have seen earlier when we had seen about the Brillouin zones. This is the V velocity versus K graph. You get this kind of curve. So we saw that there is a linear variation of V with K for free electrons, but in band theory of solids, E is not proportional to K square the way it is for free electrons. Using figure 1, this figure, E versus K curve, and the equation 3, we calculate V, the velocity. And we find that at the bottom of the energy band, that is at k is equal to 0 here, V is 0. As k increases, that is as E increases, that is we are going towards the top of the band here. Here at the bottom of the band, the velocity is 0. As we go towards the top of the band, E is increasing. E is increasing. Velocity V is also increasing, and it reaches its maximum at K is equal to 0, which is a point of inflection. Then after that, V decreases. And becomes 0 at k is equal to pi by a, which is the top of the band. Such a type of variation of velocity is not seen in free electrons. Next, we will derive the effective mass. The mass of the electron in a crystal is different from the free electron mass. Velocity of the electron in one-dimensional lattice is given by the group velocity, that is V is equal to 2 pi by h into dE by dk. This is our equation number 3, same we have written. Therefore, we can find the acceleration, that will be dV by dt. So differentiate this equation with respect to t, you get 2 pi by h into d by dt of dE by dk. Therefore, A can be written as 2 pi by h. Differentiating this, we get d square E by dk square into dk by dt. Equation 7. The electron is subjected to external field E for time dt. So now we are going to find dk by dt. So the electron is subjected to an external field E for time dt. If it acquires a velocity v in time dt, then the distance traveled is equal to v into dt, and it gains an amount of energy dE is equal to EE into V dt. Substituting equation 6, that is the velocity, we get dE is equal to E into 2 pi by h into dE by dk into dt. Here we have denoted the electric field strength by epsilon so that we do not get confused with this energy E. So dE dE will cancel out. We get, by rearranging this equation, we get dk by dt. that is 2 pi e e upon h, equation 8. Substituting equation 8 in 7, that is the equation for acceleration, a is equal to 2 pi by h into d square e upon dk square into 2 pi e e by h. So this will become 4 pi square by h square into e e into d square e by dk square. This is equation 9. Now for a free classical particle, we can write down from the Newton's second law, m dv by dt is equal to the electric force, which is given as E into E. So dv by dt will be equal to the acceleration A. From here dv by dt is E E by m, equation 10. Comparing equations 9 and 10, we define a new quantity, m star, which is equal to h square upon 4 pi square into d square e by dk square inverse. This is equation 11. So equation 9 becomes A is equal to e e by m star, equation 12. From equation 11, m star can be determined by d square e by dk square, which shows the importance of the E versus K curve for the motion of electrons. Now we will prove that for a free electron, m star is equal to m. So the energy of a free electron is given as E is equal to h cross square k square by 2m. Differentiating this equation, we get dE by dk is equal to h cross square k by m. Again differentiate this equation, we get d square E by dk square is equal to h cross square by m. Substituting in equation 11, that is the equation for effective mass, m star is equal to h square by 4 pi square into m by h cross square. So we can write down this as, we are substituting h cross is equal to h upon 2 pi. So h square by 4 pi square into m into 2 pi by h into 2 pi by h. So these pi's will get cancelled out. 2 into 2, 4, and 4 will cancel out. H and h will cancel out with h square. We get m star is equal to m for a free electron. So what is the conclusion? That all the results of the free electron theory are correct, provided m is replaced by a suitable m star. So whatever equations we have derived using the free electron theory, they are all correct. Only thing is that in all the equations we have to replace m by m star. So the equation, this equation E is equal to h cross square k square by 2m can be written as E is equal to h cross square k square by 2m star. This is called as the effective mass approximation. This is the graph of m star versus k. At k is equal to 0, m star approaches m. Then as k increases, you can see here m star is increasing. So m star increases. Reaching its maximum value at the point of inflection, then after the point of inflection, m star becomes negative. As k tends to pi by a, it decreases to a small negative value. So at k is equal to k0, m star has become negative. It was positive, it becomes negative, and then later on it decreases to a small negative value. So that means this implies a negative mass because the acceleration is negative. This can be understood from the velocity versus k graph. There, after the point of inflection, the velocity decreases, so acceleration is negative. That is, the acceleration is opposite to the applied force. So here the lattice exerts a large retarding force on the electron, that it overcomes this force and produces a negative acceleration. Next, we will derive the degree of freedom. The degree of freedom of an electron is defined by f suffix k is equal to m by m star. Substituting m star here, we get m by h cross square into d square e by dk square, equation number 13. So f suffix k is a measure of the extent to which an electron in state k is free. This is the FK versus K graph. You get this kind of curve. So from figure 4, M star is large, so FK is small. If M star is large, FK is small, that is, it is a heavy particle. When Fk is equal to 1, so in the formula m by m star, what we understand is that m is equal to m star. So it represents a free electron. Fk is positive in the lower half of the band. You can see from this graph, Fk is positive in the lower half of the band. And it is negative in the upper half of the band here. Thank you for watching this video.